All right, a lot to unpack this morning. Breaking news, we are joined by FS1 NBA analyst Chris Broussard. Chris, was this a mistake by Toronto?
Look, I will say this. Toronto is going to be better next year. With Kawhi, with Danny Green, they got much better defensively. They already were a really good team defensively. They got rid of a remnant from being swept the last 2 years in the playoffs. DeMar was their leader. And Danny Green, I think that's a big part of this because he and Kawhi are really good three-point shooters. Yeah, yep. They're tough. So I think...
Are you sure Kawhi isn't going to be hurt all next year?
He will be. He's going to have a great... keep Skip Bayless quiet season.
Really?
Yes.
Oh. He's gonna, that's a great deal for Toronto.
Well, for next year.
Yeah.
And I'll slightly favor Boston in the East. But I think Toronto is right there with Philly, and they're going to have a good chance in the East. Mm-hmm. But long term, I think it's lunacy. And I can only come to one conclusion. The general manager, Masai Ujiri, who's a great general manager, he did not want to build long-term around DeMar DeRozan. He would rather rebuild with young players than go pay him 3 years, $83 million for the next 3 years. So that is what I have to conclude, because there is no way I see Kawhi Leonard staying there. Now, I guess maybe if they were somehow to win the finals, maybe. I think even if they got to the finals, he would leave. I don't think he wants the cold weather. I think he wants L.A. I know he wants L.A. He's already upset about it. I think this was crazy long-term on Toronto's part. We know their history. Big-time American superstars do not want to live there and stay there. Vince Carter left, Tracy McGrady, Chris Bosh. DeRozan was not, he was a borderline star when he signed that contract, or a star. He's not in the class of the guys
Thank
we
you.
Mentioned.
Mm-hmm. No. Thank
okay.
You.
Kyle Lowry was
Time
a
out.
Journeyman.
Does DeRozan love Toronto?
Oh.
It's his whole
he
heart.
To be there, yeah.
He does not want to leave Toronto. He's
exactly.
been there for 9 years.
Right. He's upset.
Just for the
He's that rare American star.
Yeah, where's he from? Where's DeMar DeRozan from?
Cali.
LA.
Compton.
Yep.
Straight out of Compton.
Yeah.
And he fell in love with Toronto. Kawhi has Compton roots.
He had 9 years to fall in love with Toronto.
All right. Well,
Kawhi's got 9 months.
Okay.
He going to trade deadline.
If that. Oh. I do not see him staying. I think it was a mistake.
Kawhi is actually on his way to Vegas to participate in USA basketball with a big old middle giant foam finger for Pop. take that, because you know what happens.
That was going to be our first topic today, and that just got preempted.
It did. Hey, this makes no sense to me. Because basically you gave up. Granted, DeMar DeRozan is not a superstar. Mm. Okay, he's a fringe star player. But you gave him up for basically a rental. Yeah. Kawhi's not resigning.
Mm-hmm. How do you know that?
98.54% that Kawhi will not resign in Toronto.
Mm. I think it's even higher.
Mm. Okay, how about 99.9? So nothing's 100%. But if Kawhi re-signing with them is close, not re-signing with them is as close as a sure thing as you could possibly get, Skip. Mm-hmm. And it makes no sense that you would give up. And granted, okay, if you want to rebuild, you're going to rebuild, but somebody else is going to be rebuilding because you're going to be gone. Now, you fired Casey. You made this plunge. So let me get this straight. The coach of the year is gone. You're going to sign, you trade DeRozan for Kawhi. Kawhi going to be gone after the season, and then what? And you think the owner going to say, oh, yeah, you did a good job?
You're absolutely right.
No.
Absolutely right.
You're right. He might want to build. Somebody else going to finish this house. He got started.
You think he'll get fired?
Somebody else going to finish
it. I don't know about that. But this was a mistake. Long term, this was a mistake. Because they about to fall off the map in a few years.
So, first of all, I'm going to talk about my San Antonio Spurs. Because this is not a good deal for my Spurs. But at least they got something instead of nothing.
Right?
They did not get it. He's a near star at best. I'm not being a hypocrite about this. I'm on the record for years on this show and the other show. Not a DeRozan fan. He's not that guy. And I just got a text from an NBA authority who I've trusted for years who made the point that one guy, Kawhi, quit on his team for the whole year, but the other guy quit against LeBron in that that round of the playoffs.
You text yourself.
Yeah. I'm not.
That definitely had a big thing to do with this trade. Yeah. Like they lost their faith in him.
That's
like,
when Masai said, you know what?
He's not our
leader.
He's
just not that guy. Right. He's the face of our franchise. He led us in scoring the last seven straight years. He made four All-Star teams. He's not that guy who can take you home.
If he'd had one big game, Skip, mm-hmm. you could say, you know what, he did have a 30-point night. He had a 40-point night. But you can't have those shooting nights that he had and says, okay, he's the guy.
He's averaged 20 points a game for his whole nine-year career, which is
pretty good.
Yep. But they're always a quiet 20 to me. Right. That's just to me. And again, when I'm rooting against Toronto, I just don't ever fear him. I feared Kyle Lowry more for making shots, big shots.
He's up and down.
Yeah, but he's way up and down. Right. So I'm a Masai fan because he's a stud now. He's a dynamo.
That's why I'm surprised at this.
Okay.
But you like it.
But he plunged on the Carmelo trade. Remember when he was running the Nuggets back in February 2011? You were close to all this. But he just plunged. He said, I'm getting Carmelo up out of here, and I'll give him his wish. I'll send him home to New York where he was born. And I'm going to get back Wilson Chandler and Raymond Felton and Gallinari and Mozgov. And that's a pretty good haul for Carmelo. And we will restock our cupboard. And those next 3 years there, they were pretty good, right? They're pretty good. Well, he just plunged again. And I'm going to remind you, he's close friends with Barack Obama. Just this past Monday, they were in Kenya together and opened a sort of a sports and educational institute there for the kids. And he's got dynamic speaking abilities. He tries to create deeper interpersonal relationships with his players, which a lot of GMs just keep a hands-off approach, but he wants hands-on. So he's convinced in his mind he can convince Kawhi. Toronto's a great international city. I don't know if you spent much time there, but it is really great. Now, it's in Canada and it gets cold and we know all that, but still, it's a city that will embrace Kawhi, whether he's going to embrace back or even try, I don't know. But my point is, Masai is thinking, I got a chance. If you give me those 9 months, I got a chance. And I got Drake on my side, and I'm not laughing about that because he is Drake.
Well, remember Jay-Z with the Nets. Everybody thought he's bringing LeBron. He's bringing everybody.
Okay, but Drake is more part of the Raptors. They're the Drakes, man. I mean, he's courtside a lot of nights, not every night, but a lot of nights.
The baby dinosaurs has no chance of keeping Kawhi. Yeah.
But do you think Kawhi is not even the type to be
pop
culture? I don't
see
him being influenced by Drake.
Okay, but it's worth the plunge to try. Like Dwayne Casey, you kept winning 50 games. What'd you win this year? 59 games. Best in the East, best in your franchise history. But then you get swept for a second straight year by LeBron. In the last 3 years, you're 2-12 against the Cleveland Cavaliers in the postseason. And Masai says, I've seen enough. I'm going to plunge. I'm going to wipe my slate clean. I'm going to start over with Kawhi Leonard and with Nick Nurse. I don't know anything about Nick Nurse. I don't know who knows how he'll be. He was a good D-League coach, like Phil Jackson.
I like Nick. I think he'll be all right.
So then you just see if you can plunge. There's no LeBron. All of a sudden, to your point, it opens up a little more, if not a lot more, and you got Kawhi Leonard, and you still got Lowry, and Van Vliet was coming off the bench as your fire starter and your second team guy. But you got a shot to go win it. What if they just go, what if they got to their first finals next year? What if they did?
I still don't believe that.
I think they got a shot. Yeah, I think long term, man, it was a mistake. I don't think there's any chance. And Skip, you're right. I think Toronto's a great city.
Right.
But I tell you what, because I've been up there to cover a lot of games and spent some time there, playoff series. You feel it. It ain't America. And you feel that when you're there. I mean, you don't get the same sports channels there that we get here. And matters.
Yeah.
You grew up watching certain channels, and you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Now, you can order special packages and all that. It's just different. And,
especially
I don't want to say anything
that's going there. DeMar DeRozan got drafted there. He's used to it. It's kind of like going, if you get drafted by the New England Patriots and you have to deal with Coach Belichick, it's a lot easier as opposed to coming from somewhere else and dealing with him because that's, you know what to expect because you've been there. DeRozan was there for 10 years. Kawhi's going to probably be there at least by the trade deadline. Mm-hmm. He'll be in that
league. Okay, so Kawhi's people, translation uncle, made it known that he does not want to go to Toronto. Yeah. So you've got a disgruntled star in San Antonio who now has to leave San Antonio, but he has to go to Toronto. Well, I'm still not sure this is where I'm with you guys on this. The big X factor here, is he even going to try next year? Seriously. This is a weird dude.
I think he'll want to. Like, I think consciously he'll, like, I know I got to play my best.
Will his heart be in it?
Well, that's the question. Oh. I don't know if his heart will be in it. And you're right. Maybe that could be a factor. Subconsciously, if you're not motivated, you don't want to be there.
Well, Masai should figure that out before you make that plunge. You need to talk. Well, first of all, Kawhi ain't talking to anybody. So you can't pick up the phone and call him and say, Kawhi, we thinking about making a trade. What do you think about this? So
I'd be curious. Do you think Masai got any conversation with him?
No. No way.
I don't know.
I would think that you would think that once they agree to terms, that there's some conversation. If not with Kawhi, then with the representation.
Okay, but wouldn't you want to talk to your star?
But like you said, he's going to try to convince him over these 9 months.
Yep.
My thing is this, and you're right. I mean, DeRozan is not the leader of a championship team. But with LeBron gone, like that was their problem. Their problem wasn't Boston. I'm not saying they definitely would have beat him. But their problem wasn't Boston. Their problem wasn't Philadelphia. It was LeBron James. So you had to feel like new coach, we'll tweak some things. Let's see if we can go for it. And my feeling is this, Skip. Look, when they lose Kawhi, they're going to fall off the map into irrelevance.
Okay, that's fine. But right now, do you think Masai thinks that he gave up too much for Kawhi Leonard? Because I don't think he does.
No, but he's under the assumption, though, Skip.
You didn't give up a championship.
He thinks he can re-sign Kawhi because this is the only
that's
way
the
that
whole,
makes sense. Yeah.
That's the
he
whole
better resign him, Chris.
They're going to fall. And look, I'm telling you, right now, they're looking at the Raptors and saying, yeah, we're 50 wins every year, but we don't go to the finals. But you know what? When you fall off into the lottery and you stay there for 5 straight years, you're going to be looking at the DeMar DeRozan, Kyle Lowry era saying, I wish we had that again.
Yeah.
Especially in a city like I don't even think, I get it. I like it that he's going for the championship this year. But in Toronto, you just need to be really good.
Yes.
If you don't win they may never win a championship. Mm-hmm. Utah's never won a championship, but it's a great franchise.
At least you win 50-55 games, you give the fans something to cheer about, Skip. You win 20
games. What if you just merely got to your first finals in your franchise history?
They're not going to the finals.
All right. I'm just saying.
I mean, it would be a good, like I said, I do think they got better this year.
I think
they got a shot in the East.
Kawhi is better than DeRozan. Yeah, that's no question.
And Green helps.
They're a better defensive team with Ibaka and Kawhi and Van Fleet and
Lowry. But I told
Lowry.
You, I love Anunoby. I just think he's...
Yeah.
I'm not saying he's a star, but he's a bona fide starter. Mm-hmm. He can defend. He can score. He's long. He's 6'8". I thought he was going to be in the deal. And if you give me both DeRozan and Anunoby and Jakob Poeltl, who's 7 feet, 260 pounds.
Yeah, he's
with
not
skills.
Bad.
He's
yeah.
not bad. Yeah. He's the ninth pick in the draft.
But think about, Skip, let this sink in for a second. The Spurs went from wanting Jaylen Brown, Jason Tatum, Rozier, Josh Hart, Kyle Kuzma, and Brandon Ingram to maybe Saric, Fultz, and Covington to taking DeMar DeRozan and Danny Green.
Well, I'll say this. DeRozan's, don't you think he's the best player of all the guys you mentioned?
But I think the upside of Tatum is better than DeRozan.
Tatum, of course, yeah.
I know, but what they're looking at is we got a four-time All-Star. At least you got a viable player.
I think the Spurs did okay. Yeah. Like, they're still going to be
the Spurs.
Fifth, sixth. Yeah, they're going to be winning close to 50 games and in the playoffs every year. And they're not going to win a championship with this team, but they're going to be there. And Pop does make guys better.
Yeah. So final question for you, Chris Broussard. In terms of incentive, right? So you said at least short term, you see Toronto being better this
next
1 year. Yeah. Okay. But if it goes the way a lot of people, Shannon Sharpe, one of them, saying, we all know Kawhi's going to end up in L.A. anyway. What's Kawhi Leonard's incentive to play maximum level basketball for Toronto with this 1 year?
You still have to show that you can play.
Right.
Because you sat out 1 year, and now if you don't, you know, because some people are wondering, well, is this injury, is he going from a top five player to a top 15 or 20 or 25 player?
Right.
And he wants to get the max deal next year. So, yeah, he's still.
He's going to put that work in.
Okay.
He's going to look
real
good.
The question will be his heart. Is his heart into it?
Head case.
Stop it.
Case.
This was your guy.
All-time
head case. I know it. What, and, 5 months ago?
Until
this was
Chris Broussard predicted MVP this year, and he crumbled.
So you,
I'm hurt.
It's your fault, Chris.
You know who I'm predicting next year?
LeBron.
53 wins at the Lakers.
I'm with you on that.
No, we don't want you with us.
Oh, you got 53 wins?
It's too many.